all of you, dear children of class 8. This is a video for you this week, and I have come with some important topics from lesson number 3, chapter number 3. This is economy and economic entities, and today we are going to discuss about the importance of consumers and importance of household. Consumers are all the people who consume, who are using a commodity, they are called consumers. And household refers to a family unit where you have your father, mother, your brother, sister. So that entire family is a household. So separately we'll discuss. The first is point number 3.5.1, importance of consumers. Now, why are the consumers important in an economy? It is because of these five factors. The first is the source of demand. Consumer means they create demand. If the consumers are not there, there will be no demand. And all the producing unit will be shut down. If I have a shoe factory, and the shoe factory, I am producing shoes, but if no consumer is demanding it, then I'll be compelled to shut down. So they are very important because, and the very first point is because they are the source of demand. That means they create demand. They are the person who create demand. Whenever anything is produced, it is produced for the consumer. So they are the source of demand. Second is the influencing the pattern of demand. Pattern of demand means what kind of design, this is the design. What kind of a commodity of what design do you should I make depends upon the liking of the consumers. What are the consumer liking? What do the consumer like? I need to produce, I am producing for consumer, I need to satisfy consumer, and whatever the consumer likes, I need to produce the same thing. If I do not do that, then I would not be able to produce long. And it is because of this, consumers influences the pattern of production. Next is the influencing the structure of production. Structure, should it be a large scale or a small scale? Should it be more produced more, or should the company or the farm or the factory produce less? All are decided by the consumer. Are the consumer demanding high? Are the consumer demanding less? Are they using it every day, regularly, or are they using it sometimes? So, the pattern of the production, the structure of the production is also decided by the consumers. The next one is the stimulus mass scale production. It is because of the consumer that something is produced on a large scale. If there are large number of users, then you need to produce in a large amount. If less number of users are there, you need to produce less. And should you produce more or less depends upon what is the reaction of the consumer. So, the more the consumer, bigger should be the production, and lesser the consumer of a particular brand of a commodity, lesser should be the production. That is, it stimulates. It is because of the consumer that the this mass scale production means large scale production. Large scale production is important as well as feasible and possible. Next is expansion of the service sector. Expansion of the service sector means the consumer stimulates production. That means it is because of the consumer that the large scale production is possible. That means more and more is being produced. But to produce more and more, have you thought that laborers, more and more laborers are required? And when you need more and more of the laborers, then this is the expansion of the service sector. They get service, they get job opportunity. So more and more consumers means more and more demand, and more demand means more and more of the laborers or the workers are required. So it creates, the consumer create the job opportunity as well. So for this reason, we find the consumers very, very important in an economy. The next topic is 3.5.2. It is importance of household. Household means family. What is the importance of a family in an economy? The first is the important as consumers. A household consists of some members, and all the members are human beings. They need to eat, they need to use the commodity in order to survive. I need to wear clothes, and if it is cold, some warm clothes, shoes, and I need to eat. So when I am eating, when I am wearing those commodities, those substances, I am consuming. So household as a consumer is also a very, very important concept. So they are economic, important economic entities. Consumer, households are also important economic entities. So they are important as consumers. Households are important as consumers. Next is supplier of factor services. Household means your father, mother, brother, sister. Now you must have noticed that your father must be going to some offices, mother must be going to work, isn't it? So that means the household is the supplier of factor service. They provide their labor. So this is another important function performed by the households. They not only consume, but they provide their service also. They are service providers. And service is a very important concept, because with the help of the service provided by the laborers, by your father, by your mother, by my father, by my mother, that the economy prosper, the production takes place. Imagine if your father had not worked, and if this is to take place with every fathers in India, then there will be no production. We will die of hunger. So, household as supplier of factor services. When we say factor service, it means their service, their labor. Next is the source of saving. When we earn, we save also. And that saving is very important, because in the previous class, with class 9, I was discussing that saving is the first stage of investment. When we save continuously, in a long run, after many months and years, the same small amount of maybe 10 rupees will become a lakh of rupees. It will take time, of course, but one day I will be accumulate a big amount, but I have to begin with the saving. And saving begins with the income. Household, they work, and when they work, they earn. From the earning, we can save a little, and that saving becomes a big amount in the form of capital, and it is the capital again which can be invested. I can start a business, I can start a factory where some good many number of laborers I may hire. So it will create the job opportunity as well. And this is the way country prospers and the country grows. So from this angle also, households are very, very important. And the last one is source of revenue for the government. Revenue is the tax that we pay to the government. When I buy this, when I buy this for 20 rupees, maybe 1 or 2 rupees will definitely go to the government also. Every cloth that I am wearing, when I buy this, though I will not be paying it directly, but a part of this will go to the government in the form of the tax. So that means households are also paying tax. So they are taxpayers. And when we pay the tax, it is the tax which is the income for the government, and the same tax that has gone from us, the government utilizes for the development of an economy. So they are important because they are taxpayers. Consumers are also the taxpayer. Consumers are also important. Households are also taxpayers. They are also important. So these are some of the importance of the households, and these were some of the importance of the consumers. So consumers and the households are basic and important economic entities in an economy. And with the help of these economic entities, economy grow. So dear children, is some of the importance I have discussed. Hope you understood this. In doubt, if you have doubts, then of course get in touch with me. I am always there to help you out. And so we shall meet again the next week. I wind up this class with this, and when we shall meet the next week, we shall discuss the importance of some other economic entities. So thank you, and take care of yourself.